Welcome to Web Style Brass. In this video, I am going to show you how easy it is to implement subscribe to download in WordPress by using Contact Form 7 and MailChimp for free. Every website offers its visitors at least one free promotional downloadable that can convert the visitor into a customer down the line. Even if you have a small business, you can yourself set up a free subscribe to download functionality in WordPress website. First of all, create a free MailChimp account. It will give you a ready-to-use email list. More contacts or subscribers can be added to this list. You can view this list by going to All Contacts under Audience from MailChimp dashboard. Then proceed to WordPress and install a plugin named as MC4WP MailChimp for WordPress. Search for MailChimp for WordPress. This is the plugin we are looking for, MC4WP. Install, activate, proceed to its setting, link MailChimp account with it by adding API key from MailChimp. Click Get Your API Key Here link and it will take you to API key page in MailChimp. Make sure you are already logged in to MailChimp. From this page, click at the button that says Create a Key. Copy this key and paste it in Plugin API Key Settings. Hit Save Changes and you will see plugin status as connected. After it is connected to your MailChimp account, it will show you list name here. That means link has been created. Now go to form page. From here you can see email address field with name email in capital letters. Add first name and last name fields. First name, last name, add to form. You can see the name attribute values for first name and last name. This is FNAME and this is LNAME. You can save this form and use it, but we will not save it because we will use Contact Form 7 to create our subscription form. But we will just copy these. Name email, name FNAME, and then name LNAME. We will need these attributes. Now go to integrations page. Here click at Contact Form 7. Here you can see to integrate with Contact Form 7, configure the settings below and then add this shortcode to your CF7 form markup. Copy this shortcode. Now go to Contact Form 7, Contact Forms and add new. Subscribe. Use three fields. First name, last name, and email. Use name attribute values that we copied along with the short code. I will remove this code. And here is our first name with FNAME in capital. This is the last name with LNAME. This is our email with email in capital. Then we will use short code. And after that, submit button with value subscribe. Save the form and then adjust other settings. Now you do not need to receive email from this form, but if you want new subscription notification, you can use it. You can use an email like noreply@yourdomainname.com. But that email address should exist in your domain. Subject can be new subscription notification. We have got these fields. First name, last name. Just subscribed. That's it. Then configure mail to. Here email will be this. Subject will be, let's say thank you. Message will be first name, last name, thank you for subscribing. Now this is thank you email. We want to send a file along with this thank you email. So we will use this field, file attachments. Here we will copy the path for the file. And we have got the file. We'll go to media library. This is the PDF file. Copy its path. Here in mail to file attachments, paste the path here. But this path is not correct. If you save the form will give you error. It will tell you that this path is not correct. If the file is in media library, remove this part from the path. Start from the uploads without slash. Save. And as you can see now, the error has gone. So admin will receive this email that this user just subscribed. That will be just a subscription notification. And then user, that is sender, he will receive a thank you email with this file as an attachment. Save the form. And now we'll have to use this form by using this short code in our website. But before that, let's change this message. Thank you for your message. Thank you for subscribing. Save. Now let's implement this form in a page in our website and try it. Copy this short code. Go to a page in your website. Edit the page. Search. I am using Elementor, so I am searching short code widget from here. Let's add it here and put that short code here. Update. So this is first name, last name, your email. Sign me up for the newsletter. Page has been updated. Let's refresh the page. So when we'll fill up this form and hit subscribe button, new subscriber will be added to this list. So user or visitor will be subscribed and he will receive the file that we are sending him. But before that, I want to show you one setting. That is here. Go to plugin settings and go to form. And from here, go to its settings. This option, use double opt-in. Disable it. And hit save changes. And that's it. So let's try this form. I will use my own email address here. So name, let's say John Doe. And here is the email. Sign me up for the newsletter. Subscribe. Thank you for subscribing. If we go to the audience and all contacts page, refresh this page and you can see one new subscriber has been added here with the status subscribed, first name, last name and email address. So we have got the subscriber. Let's see if subscriber got the attachment or not. This is the notification for admin that you can choose to receive or not. John Doe just subscribed. And this is the thank you email that subscriber will receive. John Doe, thank you for subscribing. And he received the attachment file in his email. It can be promotional material or anything that you want to send him. So you got the subscriber and you sent him a file or attachment in thank you email. You could have added to this message that thank you for subscribing. Please check your email to download the file. And you could also change this button from subscribe to download. Like, go to contact forms, subscribe. And here you could say, free download. And then from messages, thank you for subscribing. Please check your email for download link. Save. Refresh. Now this makes more sense. Free download. Hit free download and then message will say thank you for subscribing. Please check your email for download link. Or you can just say please check your email for download link. And you can improve this form by using some CSS. But that's the whole concept. And MailChimp free account and a free contact list should be enough to get you started and collecting emails from visitors. This is how, in few minutes, you can set up subscribe to download functionality by using contact form 7 and MailChimp free account. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.